the audio check? Quick check. Hello. Good morning. Or it shouldn't be morning for most anybody. Good afternoon. Good evening, I guess, is the better way to say it. Hope everyone's doing well today. This is. Oh, I. Wait, hold. I need to disable that timer. That's gonna bug me. Oh, the tournament is over. Talking about the tournament, can you guys believe that I got freaking third? Isn't that insane? Okay, that timer's disabled now. It shouldn't pop up anymore. Yeah, so we had our tournament earlier. We had Tanuki, Crystal, and myself get third. You were robbed. You should have gotten third. Well, you should have been there on time, bitch. Like, you just love robbing people of VIP this month? Exactly. You know. You got that copy pasta too, Mac Lomba. Okay, Chad, I have a question. For people who have the copy pasta, do you guys like save it in like one of those like notepad apps? Look at this. You guys are so DOM. Look at this shit. I have a job, yeah. Hashtag can't relate. Sorry, you can't even see my eyebrows with these frames sometimes. That's why I don't like wearing the headsets. You have it on a notepad? See, I knew it. I knew it. You guys are so predictable. Yeah, sorry that I'm a bit late. I know it's 4 p.m. for me, so it's probably like it's about 7 for the EU viewers. So I'm sorry. I went for a bike ride, I ate lunch, and then I had to do chores and shit. So hi Kobo, hi Kobo, welcome in. The lighting looks so bright, yes, because my bedroom it faces west. So past like 3 p.m. I get direct sunlight, so it makes my room a lot brighter. Like even if I turn my ring light on, it's still fairly bright. But imagine I had this lighting all the time. It would look freaking sick. Okay. So the plan for today is simple. I decided I'm gonna paint my nails off stream. Look how long these are. It's kinda crazy. I'm gonna paint these offline tomorrow. Because I don't wanna paint them today. Because I think what I want to try and do, like, I need to let my nails breathe. Because I usually just remove the polish and then repaint them right away. But if you keep doing that, it's gonna lead to like discoloration on your nails. Like you can kind of see they're a little bit pink. So I think I'm gonna leave them like bare for a day. So I'm gonna paint them offline tomorrow. Hi, welcome in, Wolf. Hope you're doing well, even though we just chatted. Imagine not having Aurora. I know, right? I know. But you know what? We're gonna find her today. We're gonna find her today, guys. Crossing my fingers. So, we're basically gonna be Aurora hunting all stream. I think I can go for maybe like 2, 3 hours. What was I gonna say? Like, the strategy I think will work is if we do find a penguin and we bring it back to our island, then that means the next time we do Aurora hunting, it's more likely that she will spawn because the penguins are already rare. So yeah, well, chat can do polls for certain characters if I like them. You've been painting yours black for 2 years and the art stained? Huh? That's like unheard of. That's unfair. Yes, Krista, we all know you have Aurora. There's no need to rub it in my face. Okay, so we can go ahead and get started. You get gel? Oh, that could actually be it then. Okay. We're gonna use this scene today. I'm also listening to music, so. I mean, you guys can't hear it, but you can see what I'm listening to. Okay. Let's get started. So I did log into the game to like just see if I still had the empty plot because Yuka did move out technically on Friday. You got me wrapped around your finger. Yeah, that song. I used to hate this single, but now it's aight. It's aight. Okay. We gotta change our fit, because, you know, if we do happen to meet her, we gotta look cute, right?
You keep me wrapped around your finger, wrapped around your finger.
Oh my god. I was talking to my mom, because I was doing chores and shit. And she's like, man, Megan, you talk so loud. She's like, you were like screaming and shit. I'm like, yeah. It do be like that. Wait, should I try and see if I have a green suit coat? Get the Meg Esports fit again? I got a pink suit. I think that's a bit too extra, honestly. From rags to riches. Okay, I'll find something else. Yeah, I was gonna say, it looks like something out of an anime. But I was like, I was gonna make that joke, but then I didn't know which anime I could refer to. Oh my god, this has to be my favorite dress in the whole game. What color, though? Ooh. I'm thinking. I think this pink is too similar to my skin tone in game. Can't wait for the wedding stream. I know. What color does Aurora wear? She wears like a red sweater. Match with her? Nah. We ain't a couple yet. Oh my god, perfect. See, I like this wig, but I don't like how it shows the character's ears. I think it looks funny, kind. Should I wear glasses? They have cute ears. I think it looks weird. Let's wear glasses. You know, I'm wearing glasses. You know, she's gotta see the real me. You were struggling to get this stream earlier? Yeah. I mean, it's fine. You know, I shill sometimes, and if it don't happen, it's fine. Okay, I think those blue pumps are perfect. You know, classic. This is classic. Okay, I think this is solid. This is good. Okay, so I think I need to... I might have a few leftover tickets. I'm not sure. Yeah, see, the plot is still available. So we have only till today. Do you think you'd wear this outfit IRL? Maybe. It's just, like, the issue that I have is that I got a big tummy. So, usually dresses to where, like, the waistline is higher looks better on me. Or, like, if it cinches right below the bust, it kind of hides my tummy. We have to see where the waistline is on this dress, though. Oh, I was cooking last night because I was trying to grind some money. But I'd love to wear something like this. Because, like, I've been noticing that my legs and my arms have slimmed down the tiniest bit. But my tummy is still fairly big. So, because, you know, I don't do any core exercise. Because, like, I only really bike, but I know I should be doing more, like, aerobic type stuff. Hi, Jakey. Welcome in. Hope we're doing well today, hun. Oh, I have 5 tickets. Okay, 5 is good for now. We're gonna find her within 5 islands, right? Rat? Rat is rat. Okay, I think we are good to go. I don't like how my glasses look. I think it's weird how like it looks like the glasses are sitting in front of their face. It's funny kind. It's how it is, but it throws me off. Okay, you guys know what time it is. Best look on Aurora, she's your all-time fave. I know, she's my favorite too. It's because she's literally just like me. Probably gonna lurk? Okay, no problem. We appreciate the lurkers. Okay, Chatter's prediction is up. Do you think we will find her on our first attempt of the day? That'd be crazy if we did. A lot. Like, this song is so catchy. Like, it's only 4 p.m. in game, but we're already getting, like, the golden hour lighting. Golden hour lighting. We have 10 points to believe, okay. I see. Dude, imagine we have a reunion. And we run into each other in the rain. Come on, this has to be it. Wait, I forgot. I was gonna put AMI in the title. This will go crazy, yeah. It'd be just like, what's it called? What's the one movie with Ryan Gosling or some shit? I've never seen it. We'll put AMA in the title because I want chatters to ask me questions today. You know, I gotta farm you guys for content. The Notebook, that's what it is. I've never seen it. I've never seen it. Yeah, so chatters, you can ask me anything within reason. Because, you know, I have no content, I have no ideas. And it's probably more chill. So. Dude, it'd actually be crazy if we found her today. Anything? As long as it... If I don't feel comfortable, I won't answer it. Can you sing WAP? No. I think you're trying to get me to be like, oh, I can sing it, like I'd be able to, but do I want to? No. Never. Like I said, 1 million subs and I'll sing it. Because the thing for me is, like, once you stream something, you can't really unhave it on the internet. Because, you know, people can screen record, they can clip. So it's like, I know I'm very careful with what I say. Like, there's certain words that I won't say. There's certain songs that I won't sing. Because some are, like, a bit too explicit. Don't do anything you don't want to do. Exactly. See, you get it. You understand it. I think just in general, not necessarily consent with, like, physical things, but also, like, verbal things when establishing boundaries, it's so important. Because you don't want to disrespect anyone. You don't want to hurt anybody's feelings. Especially when you're making new friends. I think it's important to establish boundaries. Have you stopped taking baths finally? No, I will never not stop taking baths, okay? Any place that I move into has to have a bathtub. I refuse to take a shower, okay? You know why? I can barely stand sometimes. So, like, imagine I fall and crack my head open in the shower. That'd be the worst. So don't ridicule me if I don't like showers. How do you wash your hair if you take baths? Oh, we have like little plastic. What'd you call it? It's like a little plastic mini bowl that it's like a bowl, but it has like a little lip on it. It looks like a little like prep bowl, but plastic. Like, you know, like a mixing bowl. Even at your new place, you'll take baths. Yeah, like I said, any place I possibly move into has to have a tub. My mom used it on me when I was a baby. We have had those little plastic bowls for literally years. Yeah, you could just dip your head back, but I don't like doing that because sometimes like the water gets in your mouth and it's icky. Okay, I'm gonna self-report for a second, but I feel like every kid, when they would take a bath, they would like try and drink a little bath water. I think everybody had to do that at least once, right? It's not just me. I think everybody had to do it at some point, right? I would like to clarify, I don't do it anymore. But I was little, like, it would happen. It's just you? No, I mean like a child, like 10 and under. Okay, kids do some gross shit, okay? It's kinda like how everyone has like eaten their boogers. Everybody's done it. Babes, I wouldn't admit that. True. But you know, this is a sub-only stream, I'm not gonna leak. I'm totally not gonna repost this clip and screenshot the chat messages. If you're 10 is- No! I bathe myself, dumbass. I think our parents stopped- or my mom stopped helping me take a bath when I was like 7. Because my hair was like really difficult to manage, so she would like comb my hair when I'd take a bath. You only drink water from the hose as a kid? I never did that shit. Because I just equated everything outside to be dirty or, like, disgusting. I would have taken that to the grave. But you know what? I feel comfortable sharing that because it's a little wholesome story. And I think, even if you guys say you didn't, I think every kid at some point has accidentally or intentionally drank in their bathwater. Yeah, I would have... Jakey, weird champ, weird champ. I'd be one of the kids who would fake taking a shower. Ew. Ew. See, like, I liked getting clean and stuff. Oh, you know what I hated? What I would fake? I would fake brushing my teeth. So, I would, like, wet the toothbrush. And then, later in the night, my dad would, like, touch my toothbrush. He was like, oh, it's not wet enough. And then he would, like, forcibly brush our teeth. It was really painful, mind you. But I just hated the idea of brushing my teeth. Because, like, my gums are really sensitive. So I just hated brushing my teeth. And like him forcibly brushing our teeth didn't make it any better. But you know. That was an L on their part. Concerning parenting, I guess. I would fake brushing my teeth as well. See, it's not just me. See, Mac is like literally an iPad kid. You're like 2 years younger than me, man. Literally an iPad kid. Even now, that's why I hate brushing my teeth. Because I just remember, like, my gums bleeding. But, you know, it's fine. Oh, shit. Well, you know what? That's not her. Sad. I'm gonna go home, cry dad now. Ew, who is that? So mean. I think autocorrect kind of clapped you there, Crystal, because you were talking shit. I think it could tell. Yeah, I can't go a day without bathing either. Because, like, any type of, like, sweat that builds up, it really bothers me. I do wash my hair every day, which I know is not necessarily healthy for my hair type, but like feeling like my scalp gets sweaty and me not being able to clean it really bothers me. I can't do it. Oh, this is another song I really like from Set It Off. I can't really sing it because the verses are a bit too short almost. What do you mean refresh? Mac.
Baby, I don't wanna go to bed.
Oh, this part's nice.
I just sing awkward silence like we skipped a beat. Words that burn.
I don't know who is the featured artist, but their voice is really pretty. It's not often that Set It Off has a female vocal feature.
I don't wanna chase you, rather hear you scream.
People who say it's unhealthy to shower every day are nasty. I mean, is there like studies and shit? Cause like you're washing off your body's oils or something. I know for me, like, I can't go to bed knowing that I didn't wash up. Oh, it's a hair keeping technique. Okay. I don't know anything about that. And I have no interest in learning. I should honestly probably take better care of my hair, but like, I just washed it. Washing it every day removes your natural oils. What does it do, though? Like, what does it do? Because I just washed up. Like, I didn't put the... Because I have leave-in conditioner. I don't use it every day. Because it's expensive, so I use it, like, every other day. I didn't put it in today, but... Like, usually when I put the conditioner in it, like, the curls are more defined. You're drying it out? Damn. Oh, okay, is that it? Okay, then that's probably it then, because my hair is always really goddamn dry. Mac actually not spreading misinformation for once? See, I think other people have experienced something like this as well, but I never really had the desire to like dress up or look cute when I was younger. It's this weird sense of like not wanting to be desirable. It's not that like I didn't have crushes or anything, but I didn't want people to like me in that way. Like I didn't take care too much of my hair. I didn't care too much about my looks or what I wore. I still don't know why I inherently thought that way. This is one of those things that I'm always perplexed whenever I think about. Another thing I heard all the time when I was younger, but everyone would be like, "Oh my god, I'm so jealous of your curly hair." And I never was jealous of people with straight hair, because like it's obviously easier for them to maintain, but I've always been like happy with how I look in that sense. Because like I was raised with the belief that you should be appreciative for anything that you have, whether it be like the resources where you live, because there's always going to be someone who's jealous of you, there's always going to be somebody who's worse off than you, so. It's not that I didn't like how I looked, it's more so I didn't take proper care of myself. Yeah, I think this is the longest my hair has been in a while. Because I went to the salon last about a year and a few months ago. I think it was last, like, July. Oh, there's a big fish! And she cut it to, like, here. Because when she treated it, it was, like, this length. But it was all damaged there. So she trimmed it to, like, here. So... yeah, so all this is the old hair still. And then everything here and up is new hair, I think. Because, like, I've been trimming it occasionally. Hair is really long? Like, how long? My sister's is all the way down to her ass. But she has, like, straight, wavy hair. Come on, big shark, big shark. Guys, I'm done. Oh, so you can see that sunbeam right here. Yes, it's like lined up right here. To your lower back, really? And was it like still like were the curls as tight and defined? Because like if it were like that, it'd be like Merida hair. Oh, why am I listening to this song? I don't really like the song. Controversial. Well, it's not letting me skip it. Oh, there again, right there. Oh, still curly, but not as nice. Okay. Long hair is so hard to maintain. I don't know. I mean, I've never had super long hair. I wish I had longer hair. I'd like to try it out. Oh, I didn't do the bug event on Saturday. Oopsie. I mean, I think the bug event is kind of mid. Especially now when there's less like tree bugs that spawn. Oh my god, for lunch? After stream, I went up to my sister because you know how last week I told her we were like, no, we cannot get McDonald's. So after stream, I went into a room like this. I was like, hey, can we get food? Because you know, like, we gotta treat ourselves and also our family. So we got Popeyes for lunch, and I got the regular chicken sandwich with just mayo, and I added Chick-fil-A sauce and avocado to it, dude. The chicken sandwich with the avocado is another level. It was so goddamn good. But from this point on, we're not going out to eat anymore. Ne never again until we move out. Because we need to save our money. Okay, I think we're ready for another expedition. We're gonna find her. You don't like avocado? What is wrong with you, Mac? Avocado's so good. It's a healthy fat as well. Surprisingly, my sister is super picky. She doesn't like fruits, veggies, but she likes avocado now. It's kind of weird. You keep on getting wall guys and fall guys. I freaking hate wall guys. It's so frustrating because people don't work together and like the actual sweats are doing tricks and shit. I hate when I get wall guys. Okay, but guys, you know what time it is. It's Gamba time. Before Twitch bans predictions, it's Gamba time. Do you think we will find Aurora on this island? Well, we got more believers this time. Majority believers? Huh? Huh? I think saying "how's the funny shit" is so good. Wait, I gotta check something real quick. 50-50? What? People are just throw. Oh, someone got brave in doubt. 1.3K in doubt, huh? One point 2K believe, 1.3K doubt. Dude, this prediction's gonna go crazy. It's another rainy island, another rainy day. Okay, chatters, my title says AMA. You guys gotta ask more questions. You guys are lacking. You guys are slacking. I should go all in. Dude, that'd go crazy. Did Mac drop in all 80,000 of their points? That'd go insane. Imagine we actually find her on that island. That'd go crazy. Do you believe in magic? No. I think coincidence is more likely the scenario than actual magic. Like, even when I was younger, like, watching magic shows, I understood that it was all gimmicky. And, like, it was more distraction than anything. It's not real. I think the reason why in, like, olden times, a lot of people believed in magic or, like, not witches, but... Like, it's just weird circumstances. And when you have a population who isn't educated, like, they'll believe anything. People are very gullible and susceptible. Magic ain't real. That's why I don't like Harry Potter again. I'll say it now and I'll keep on saying it. I don't like Harry Potter. I can never relate to the characters because it's just, it's not real. Not real. You have a good question? Shoot. I was joking, not gonna lie. Joking like how magic is a joke? Got him. Remember when I had the question book? Oh, you know what I have the desire to listen to? I'll play this for now. I want to listen to Post Malone. I looked the other. Whenever I listen to this album, I usually start at 90 to explore. I think this song, like, the background, like, instrumentals is really, like, catchy. Ooh, interesting. Do I believe tarot cards and crystal booths are real? I think it's one of those other things, kind of like horoscopes, where a lot of their predictions are general enough to where it can relate to anything in your life, because I don't think they will give you anything super specific. Like, I myself have never gone to, like, any, like, tarot card reader, because I know it's not that it's a scam. Because I think people more so do it for, like, the experience. I don't think anybody genuinely goes to a tarot card reader expecting, like, wisdom or advice. So, to answer, I would say no. I think it's because I have a firm belief that you have a lot of control in your own life. Like, you can't rely on outside circumstances for everything. Like, I know it's very easy to feel powerless, but you have a lot of self-control. You have a lot of self-agency, I think is the better word. Like, you choose how you spend your time. Yes, where you live, where you were born, like, your income growing up is a huge factor in your access to resources, but... And also luck is another thing. But you choose how you spend your time. Getting your fortune read on stream? Wait, what was- We did a gag for that one stream, I think it was. Oh wait, was anybody here for that stream? I think the gag was... what was it? Like, if you give the sub, I will read your fortune. And I would just say something super general for a gag. I think it was Titans, Mac, and Lemon who were there. I think. Does anybody remember? This was like months ago. You know what the nice part about editing VODs from months ago? Because right now I'm editing Animal Crossing from literally April and then Mario Kart from July. It's almost like I'm reliving those stream moments. Like, I can remember what I was thinking about, what chat was thinking about and saying. It's like really touching almost. Because, like, sometimes when I watch back the VOD, like, I will chuckle to myself and, like, rewatching the conversations I had previously with Chet. That's why, like, I want to go through all my VODs at some point. That's why I like doing the Mario Kart and Animal Crossing VODs for clips. Because I feel like those streams are the ones we have, like, the best and most entertaining conversations. You can see when I was a good chatter. I mean, honestly, you're kind of right. Me with the cooking competition stream. Yeah, that was a good one. I don't think I'm gonna clip that stream because, like, we didn't, like, have too many conversations because we're more so focused on the actual challenge. Ooh, they're a peacock. Like, I don't think I'm gonna rewatch that, but. Oh, they're cute, though. But, you know, not her. Sag. Peacock. Stop it. You're just proving yourself that you are a bad chatter. Come on. Come on, dude. Wait, how's my inventory full? Huh? Oh. You know, there's a reason why we don't have the C-O-C-K-A emote enabled. If you know, you know. You know, the thing about the predictions is that when it's for, like, a racing game or, like, in Fall Guys, if I win or not, it's solely based on, like, my skill. But, but for predictions like this, where it's full RNG and luck, it's ultimately Chatter's fault if you guys lose your points. Just say, no, you can't blame me at all. That what emote? No, Mac, if you're on desktop, look up what C-O-C-K is. Or C-O-C-K-A. It's Kaka. It's really funny, but I'm not enabling it. I don't even have enough emote slots available on 17 if I maxed out. You like the suspense of it? That's why gambling is bad. Chatters, do not ever gamble in real life. Because it's been scientifically proven that the reason why people get addicted to gambling and the reason why they get such big highs, they get the adrenaline off of the suspense of seeing if they win or not. That's why, like, when they lose, it doesn't feel as bad, and when they win, it doesn't feel as good. It's so funny. I know, it is a good emote, but I'm not... I'm not enabling it. Because, like, people who don't have the extension would be like, why is chat spamming Kaka all the time? That's weird. That's why we don't have, like, different versions of Poggies enabled. But, like, the arcade is no better. Yeah, like the claw machines, like, where they're essentially rigged against you. I agree. I think that is somewhat a form of gambling, but there's still, like, an aspect of skill. It's kind of like the type of games where it's, like, cards or, like, blackjack, that type of shit. There's still, like, some semblance of skill. Like, you can, like, card count and shit. But with slots, it's full RNG. Like, slots is the most degenerate form of gambling. Even, like, the lottery. I think the lottery is also super bad, because it's kind of normalized to, like, spend, like, hundreds of dollars on the lottery every month or something. Just, chatters, don't ever do it. Oh my god, Carnival Games actually rigged. Actually rigged. I myself have never won a Carnival game, but my dad, he was able to get me a plushie because it was one of those, squirt gun. It's like where you had to point the water gun at, like, the clown's mouth and the balloon would pop whenever you shot enough water on it. So, he was able to win that one because he was, one, playing against a bunch of, like, little children. And he essentially, like, had it, like, lined up and targeted before the guy, like, rang the bell to go. So, he was able to win it right away. So, you know, that was a Giga Chad move on his end. But, you know, the kids were upset. There's no way they aren't rigged. I think they're designed in a way in which you have to know how to play before you play. Like, it's for... If you want to win, you gotta be a die-hard Carnival game player. But the reason why they do well is because people like to do it for the experience. Like, you go to the Carnival to play games and ride rides. It's part of the gimmick. Have you tried those potatoes on a stick at Carnivals? No. Like, I know we're in Washington, so I guess our state fair is the Washington State Fair. I think the trademark food is like the elephant ear, which is essentially like, it's like, it's not a pancake because it's not nearly as thick, but it's like, it's a fried, like the thickness is in between a crepe and a pancake. And then it has like cinnamon jam, sometimes a bit cream, or like sweet cream cheese. Oh, the scones as well. It's another staple item at our fair.
Just wanna fly.
The tornado potato. Wait, are you guys talking about like when they cut the potato in like a spiral? I've seen videos of those. It was $15? What? Funnel cakes? Is that what those are called? I mean, they had all kinds of food at our at the state fair. I think the you know the gimmicky thing where they're like, oh, a fried pickle or fried ice cream. Like I remember those were big when I was in high school. Okay, well, Chatter, do you know what time it is? It's another Gamba time. Chatters, go Gamba responsibly, of course. Only Gamba with channel points you can afford.
Tonight.
Why is it raining everywhere? Huh? Where's my VIP? You didn't even win today, Mac. Okay, Chatters, I'm putting out a quick PSA. I don't mean to call people out, but you don't need to spell correct yourselves. We can assume what you meant. I'm not calling people out. I'm just saying some people do it, and you don't gotta spell correct. It's fine. We can assume what you're meant to type. It's fine. Like I said, it's embarrassing. No, it's fine. All or nothing? Well, as you guys can see, it's not her. I have to do it to make me feel better about yourself, but you know what? It clutters the chat room and it bothers me. So I'm saying quick PSA, you don't need to spell check in my chat. I don't care. No, okay, I care because it clutters up the chat room, but. Guys, stop agreeing with them! Remember, you're here to make me happy, not each other happy. Yeah, whenever if I'm typing in the chat and I spell something wrong or I spell an emote wrong, I'm just like, yeah, GG's. I messed up. It's fine. You know, you guys better not start unionizing though. That'd be bad. Unions are very bad. I'm trolling. I'm a proud Haas Nobby head. No, you can't not show subs when I'm union busting, okay? He said two judges heard chatters a lot so they can leave. I mean, I've said this before, but your chat room makes a stream, so if I have no chat, then I have no stream. So, you know, I guess I gotta be treating you guys with more respect. I'll make the contract. Are you gonna be the union leader? Should I do a little bit of a classic union busting? Okay, chatters. Can I call one of you guys out? I don't have it by name. But I'm looking at the prediction. And I literally closed it before when I saw who it was, okay? Some dummy dumb gambled 10 points right before I closed it. Which dumbass did that? When we already saw on screen that it was not her. Which of you guys did it? Which one? They didn't type in chat because they didn't have the little icon. But which one of you guys was it? You're calling sent. It could be a lurker. Oopsie, I don't mean to call a lurker out, but there's a reason why I closed it because I didn't want anybody to rig it. Was it you, Woof? Let's hold back our subs. Yeah, I guess. Guys, I swear it's not me. I think you're trolling. I think Wolf is coping. I mean, if you guys hold back your subs, then that means people, along with yourselves, can't watch the sub-only streams. You'd be missing out on so much fun content like today. Hmm? You know, we always joke about don't subscribe, but you're missing out on a lot of cool stuff, right? I love the home council, it's so good. Council, council. Council is such a hard word for me to say.
I ain't going nowhere.
I have VIP, so I don't need subs. No, VIPs still get ads. So when your sub runs out, you're gonna see ads again. Big Sedge. Talking about ads, Twitch is gonna make everyone run more ads. So, chatters, if you watch other streams, or mine included, just get ready for it. I know for me, I freaking hate when chatters complain about ads, where they're like, 7 ads! It's like, I'm required to run them. It's ultimately, if I don't run them, I lose my affiliate, or people lose their partnership status in some cases. And also, it's how the platform is. You shouldn't complain about it. Because, like, if I didn't have to run ads, I wouldn't. If I could run a smaller amount, I would. So, I know my rule for the chat room is don't complain. And if you complain, you get timed out. Because I don't like seeing it in chat. And another reason why people complain about ads is they don't explicitly ask for a gifted. But they're like, oh, damn, I have to watch ads now. Hoping they can bait somebody to gift them a sub. But Oilers, if you are listening, don't give those motherfuckers a sub. They're obviously baiting you. If you gamba, do you get more than you put it? It depends on how many points were distributed on the losing side. So since only believers gamba 10 points, then 10 points is split between everybody who doubted. So 4 people doubted. And it's like it's split evenly. So everyone should have gotten like 2 or 3 points. Yeah, so TLDR, Orleans, don't gift subs to people who complain about ads because they're just annoying little shitheads. Because like, the streamer can't do anything because they're required to run those ads. And it's not like the streamer's cut of the ad revenue is substantial. It's just how the platform is, so. Like, in my whole time being affiliate, no joke, out of all the ads I've run, I think I've made less than $10 from ad revenue. So to give you guys context, the only people who are making a good chunk of money from running ads is the big guys, the partnered streamers. But I'm still required to run the ad density that I have. Because I have no way to negotiate an agreement or contract unless I have a established viewership or platform. So, i.e. like, partnership numbers. Did they send you cute merch? No! No, they don't have any shit for affiliates. Which is fine. I understand when comparison to other platforms, it's very easy to be eligible for affiliate. When I say easy, I mean, like, you know how for TikTok you need 1,000 followers to go live, for YouTube you need 1,000 subs and X amount of watch hours to get, monetization? Like, it takes a long-ass time to get those numbers, but for Twitch, you just, when I say just, like I said, I'm comparing it to these other two platforms concerning video and live video. In order to get affiliate, so any form of monetization on Twitch, you need 50 followers and then 3 average viewers. I mean, the hardest part is getting the average viewers, of course. Because it's hard to have viewership when you don't have an established base or audience. So, my main point is, when compared to other video platforms, it's a lot easier to be eligible for monetization based on the base requirements. But for partnership, for baseline partner eligibility, you need an average of 75 viewers and X amount of stream hours. You don't need to have a specific amount of followers, but it's somewhat difficult to get approved for partner, because when you get a partnership badge, you're essentially like an endorsement from Twitch. So you have to basically make like an essay about yourself and how your community and also your stream is a good representation of the Twitch platform. Hi Lemon, welcome in. Did you find her yet? No, obviously not. I would be so much happier if I had found her. But hope you're doing well today. I've expressed this before. I'm not too concerned about getting Twitch partnership, because I think if you have the mentality of grinding for partner, you're just gonna see your viewership, your streamer friends, as a number, and a way to like get yourself to the top. And I don't want to conduct myself in that way. So my long-term goal with Twitch is to have an established platform to where I can make passive or livable income and hopefully build my art career. In terms of like partnership, it would be great, because you know, having a badge is pretty cool, but especially with the news of the new revenue split where partnerships are no longer going to be able to get the 70-30 split. So they're basically going to have the same split as the affiliates, so 50-50. I would love to push for Twitch Ambassador. So a Twitch Ambassador is basically an endorsement from Twitch, saying that your stream, your content, and also your chat room and community are a really good reflection of what Twitch wants to be. If you look at like Twitch's corporate accounts, you can look up what a Twitch ambassador is. But they look like a good group of people, and I would love to be a part of that. But at this time, in order to be an ambassador, you have to be a partner. So, lmao. But I've told myself, it's very common for people who apply for partner to get denied. There's been a few people who have applied like multiple times and gotten denied multiple times. So I told myself I'm only gonna apply for partner when I have like more than the requirements. Like I would wait till I have like 100 average. I would wait till I have like a good sustainable stream schedule to where I can stream like 40 plus hours a month and not be burnt out. Why is there so many Twitch tiers? It's just the three. I mean, partner's obviously the one that most people strive for, but not many people know or talk about the ambassadors. Because, like, the Twitch ambassadors, those are the people you usually see on the front page. So, you know, if Megan can be on front page consistently, that'd be epic. That's why I tell chatters you have to behave, because you guys reflect me. Well, that was cool, that focus. You guys see that? Wait, let's go full cam. That was cool. We are good chatters. Boss, pull up Max Logs where they said, Kaka or some shit. Are you grinding for Aurora for a particular reason? Because you could definitely buy her Amiibo Guard. It sounds like you're trying to backseat game, and that's not allowed. But if I wanted to buy the card, I would buy the goddamn card, okay? But we've been searching for her since literally January. January, okay? If I've gone this long without cheating, then it ruins everything. It ruins everything. You know, I love the thought of RNG. That's the way to go. You know, I don't like pay to win. I would feel like if I bought my wife, it'd be... I don't believe in human trafficking, you know? Stop, Meg. Stop drama farming. I can have karate chop? Yeah, we got pizza to shake. I suppose. Every time we do this stream, everybody's like, why don't you just buy the cart? I'm like, bitch, I got a dollar. I can easily buy the card. But, you know, I'm farming content. Like, we put Aurora searching in the title, we get lots of views. Just saying. Anyway, Chatters, go Gamba.
Had 2 points in Believe alone, though.
Sorry, I thought I broke a nail. I slammed it on the table by accident. 3 points? 13? Okay. Have I ever been in a stream with a bad chat? Yes, I have. You see it a lot in, like, the bigger streamers, because there's been a few times where I've been in, like, a bigger streamer's chat and they've gotten a hate raid, or they're getting brigaded by another streamer, like, with negativity, so, like, people, like, talking shit or, like, saying slurs or bad words, or, like, saying things to intentionally, like, farm, like, negative attention. There's also been a few times where I've been in a smaller streamer's chat and there's just people being, like, weird, like, borderline, like, inappropriate and, like, sexual. And there's not much you can do as a viewer, because you don't really want to, like, call out the chatters. And, like, the mod team will always try their best, like, to their abilities. But to me, I think it's important to maintain as safe of a chat room as you can, because everybody has a different form of boundaries, but I think there should be a baseline that should be respected. How is that allowed? It's kind of like how, I think prime example, Amaranth. I love her. I think she's great. And one of her first rules in her chat room is you can say some things that are somewhat, like, not necessarily suggestive, but, like, you can compliment her and how she looks, but you can't be, like, sexual about it. And I think there's, like, an important distinction, because, you can make your own rules in the chat room, but there's still baseline rules that you have to follow concerning, like, Twitch's terms of service. Like, even if a chat room has certain rules, a moderator can still, like, ban or timeout people. There's still Twitch staff who will ban users from the platform entirely if their chat messages are inappropriate or don't follow 2S. Not to name names, but X. Yeah! I don't watch a lot of his streams, but whenever I do, I'm just like, it's too much. It's one of those things where his platform and his viewership is so large to where a small minority kind of fucks up their reputation, and it's unfortunate. That's why when we are very small, we have to make sure we keep our morality no matter how big we grow. That sounds messy, yeah. I've been in a few streams where, like, Hassan has gotten hate rated, and it's just, like, the best thing you can do whenever that happens is just ignore it. I've talked about this before, but I've gotten follow-botted on stream one time, and chatters literally had no idea, because, I had disabled on-screen alerts, and also chat alerts, so nobody had no idea besides myself, and I didn't say anything till the end of stream, because people will do those negative things to get a reaction out of you, and you know what? I'm not gonna give them that reaction. I'm not gonna farm. Have I ever had a bad chat room before? I feel like I haven't. There were times in the past where I kind of let vulgar jokes slide. Or not vulgar necessarily, but kind of like innuendous stuff. And looking back, I shouldn't dip those in the bud. But you know, there was never an instance where, like, multiple people were being inappropriate, so. Have you had to deal with a lot of bad chatters? Not in my chat room, but in other people's chat I have. Because I used to mod for a few other smaller channels, and there was a few times where, like, people would kind of, like, say things that are kind of out of hand. Because, like I said, you want to make sure you have a baseline to make sure everybody in your chat room feels comfortable. Because just because you, the streamer, are okay with certain jokes, doesn't mean everybody watching is okay with it. I've expressed this to other people I've moderated for, but when you allow your chat room to have very vulgar or very suggestive messages all the time, it makes a lot of viewers, particularly female viewers, not want to watch your stream, because if they say you, the female streamer, allow explicit or really gross messages, it makes them feel unsafe. I know, I would not feel safe in that chat room if I saw a lot of chatters who I assume are, like, gross men saying gross things. If that was my first time in a stream and I saw, like, some really vulgar shit, I would not watch again. That's why I don't let shit slide anymore. I don't like when people itemize me. I don't like when people simp for me. Like, there's certain vernaculars and wordage that kind of, like, signals it. I think saying the words like cute or pretty is fine as long as you're referring to like a specific aspect. So if somebody says, oh, that shirt you're wearing is cute, or that dress is beautiful. But when people say like you are beautiful or you are pretty, see how that drastically changes the meaning of that sentence? Because you want to avoid any form of itemization. You want to avoid any form of people like adoring you in that capacity, because that leads to people doing not so nice things, i.e. like messaging you unwarrantedly, pursuing you when it's not appropriate. So you have to make sure you don't skirt those lines. There needs to be clear boundaries. That I'm telling this for all the small streamers or people who want to stream. This is something that you need to know before you start doing any form of content creation online, because it's very easy to be passive and let things slide. So this is like a heat of war. I'm like, don't let anybody make you feel uncomfortable. And always speak up if anybody does. Anyway, rant over. That actually changes it. Exactly. Exactly. Like, the way people word things can drastically change by taking out a few words, right? And, like, I've expressed this before, but I'm the type of person, like, I will nitpick every single word people say sometimes. That's why, like, connotation, sentence structure is so, like, important to me. Is modding difficult? It depends on, like, how much you want to try hard. Because I was the type of mod... I still have mod in a few chats, but I don't go in their stream anymore because I don't have time and I feel bad. But I think I take it too seriously, because a lot of Twitch mods, they don't get paid, they don't get compensated. So you're basically volunteering your time. I think one of my big concerns was it's kind of hard to communicate exactly what messages the streamer thinks is okay. Because there was a few instances where, like, I timed out somebody when they should have been banned. There's been a few times where, like, I've had to time out people and they got untimed out because the streamer didn't think it was a severe enough message to deserve, like, a timeout or, like, deleting the message. It's very hard to communicate when the streamer doesn't have, like, an established moderation team. Anyway, I didn't even know you could try hard it. I mean, by try hard, I mean, like... Like, when I was modding, I would have my, like, fingers on the trigger, like, ready to clap people. Like, it's kind of like... When I say, like, try hard modding, like, picture the person in a group project that goes, like, above and beyond. Like, not necessarily by, like, how they actually do the project, but, like, their mentality about everything. That's kind of how I was. And the thing with modding for someone else is, like... You can discuss how many scenarios, like, oh, you need to mod you need to ban or timeout if they say this and this. But there's always going to be a situation where, like, something new happens. And then you're like, oh, how should I act? Like, should I mod or should I ban or timeout? There's always going to be instances like that. Anyway, chatters, let's end that prediction. Did we find her? No, Big Sag. But you know what else is Big Sad? Watching ads on Twitch, because, guys... We are 1 hour into stream, so it's time for me to run a few minutes of ads. But if you are somehow a non-sub and watching this stream, what are you doing? All you gotta do is see if you got a Prime available, and you can hashtag sub for free with Prime, oh my god. Or maybe if you're lucky, you'll get a gifted. Everybody watching here should be a sub anyway, so you probably won't see the ads anyway. But if you are watching, it is the last few days of September, meaning if you've been considering subscribing, subscribe now. It's 20% off. Crazy. Anyway, we'll see some of you guys in a few. Get some water, get a snack. Okay, I don't know why. I'm like thinking back on the little tangent we went on talking about chat rooms and moderation. Like, I kind of felt like I was lecturing you guys. I'm sorry. It's just like, it's one of those topics that I feel very strongly about, because it's one of those topics where you don't want to, like, invalidate how people feel in the sense of, you want to make sure people feel safe in any type of situation, so.
You're trolling, Kobobo. You're literally trolling. You're trolling. I can't believe you.
I thought it was educational. Thank you, Wolf. Thank you. I mean, I think it's important to talk about these things sometimes, especially with, it's kind of harder to have these conversations once you have a larger audience, because everybody feels like they need to insert their opinion. And, like, I think it's also better for me to share these thoughts now when I have a majority of my audience is not streamers, so they don't necessarily, like, relate or understand everything. Because there's so many different levels to streaming that a lot of people don't know before they get into it. Like, I learned so much in my first 3 months of streaming, so. Why would Megan want to marry an Aurora Borealis? Yeah, I'm not one of those TLC people who marries, like, roller coasters. I'm not one of those who likes inanimate things, okay? I never knew marriage was mentioned. Yeah, Kobobo, like, tuning out for a minute. Lamau. Oh, that's what you seen because we did the shooting star stream last time. I've never seen an Aurora Borealis in real life. We almost got to. Because back when I was in fourth grade, my grandma, she took our family on a cruise trip to Alaska. But we weren't able to go in the time of year in which the Aurora Borealis appeared, so. Big sad. I need to see what my camera looks like for a second. I'm gonna change the ISO. Hold. It's a bit too dark. Don't they have it in Animal Crossing? Yes, it sometimes does show up at nighttime. Okay, I think this color is good. It sometimes shows- Ooh, wait, look at this curl right here. Ooh. Look at that. Okay, that looks a lot better. It's not as washed out. I'm just gonna have to remember to change my ISO settings on Tuesday. Chatters remind me if it's too dark. Kobe having a breakdown. Okay, it looks like we've wiped out this island. I mean, I think you're trying to say that I tried to gaslight you into thinking it was actually the Aurora Borealis, but it's not. You just made these assumptions on your own and you're trying to blame me when it's not really my fault. Sorry. I did the voice crack wanting to, like, fake cry, but I was like, nah, let's not take this bit too far. I think the sweats come out at night. What? Huh? I mean, if I was searching for Aurora Borealis, why would I start at 5 p.m.? That'd be kind of silly. Like, honestly. The theatrics. I did take drama in junior high. I think I took it in seventh grade. Oh, the players? I mean, nighttime is when more kids play, I assume. You know, like everybody's coming back home from their stepdad's house, so you know, mom has the switch at her house.
Be gone every day, oh.
Okay, we are heading into our fifth island. Still no luck. I'm gonna go cry. That's a read. Were you good in drama? No. I've only recently become extra. I think it's because I've gained a lot more self-confidence. I was so nervous in drama class, like. Thankfully, electives in junior high were only half a year. Because we had semesters. It was horrible. It was bad. I took it hoping I could gain more confidence, but it just made me worse. Anyway, Chatters, you know what time it is. It's Gamma time. Do you think we'll find Aurora on this island? Her name is so goddamn hard to say. I'm talking really loud. I'm sorry. I'm sorry to my family because everybody's home right now. Do you have to fake crying drama? No, I don't think so. We would just have to like make skits and stuff. Damn, we have no doubters? Crazy. Oh, never mind. Okay, please. Wait, everybody, we're supposed to be praying. You guys know the meta for Aurora streams? We have to pray. Everybody has to P-Side2 pray for her. Everybody forgot. Everybody keep praying. We'll find her one day, Copium. I will not be praying. I don't want you to find her. Guys, I think Crystal's a fake fan. They want me to be sad and lonely forever. How long have I been looking for her? Since January. Because from my first affiliate stream, I deleted my Animal Crossing live on stream and we started a new save. And on my original island, I was literally best friends with Aurora. I had two photos of her. Two. I was the real one. She was my actual in-game wife. But I had to delete her. I had to do it.
You probably think that you are better now. Better now.
So I literally deleted her. Why am I axe busting? So we've been searching since January. That's why, as I said earlier, if I just buy an amiibo card, it would make all the time we've spent searching mean nothing. She was like your fifth villager, has never asked to leave. I remember she asked to leave like two times on my original island, but she had stayed there for like, basically my whole save for about a year. You chose Twitch over wifey? I mean, you wording it in that way, where in which I chose content over the love of my life, is kind of rude, but you know, kind of true. So, I guess you're kind of right, but being able to clickbait Aurora searching every time we do this is kind of good for clicks, so. I miss anything? Did you find her? No. Guys, the moment we find her, I would change the title to Once Again Reunited with the Love of My Life. That's what the title would be. You guys know this. No. I would be like, I'm engaged? Question mark, exclamation point. When is the wedding? AMA. Dude. Dude, imagine this title. Oh, it's not her. Damn. AMA. Wait, imagine this title. I'm getting married? And then AMA. Dude, imagine how crazy that title would go. Classic clickbait YouTube.
I'm getting married. AMA.
Did we find her on this island? No. If you find her off stream, that'd be tragic. Yeah. I would still screenshot it on Twitter and hope I could farm some, like, likes or something. But I don't know, chatters. I have a very small following on Twitter. If everybody could politely go, go follow my Twitter, that'd be great. Oh, another thing that Twitch looks at if you're qualifying for partner is they look at your other social media. Meaning, you don't necessarily have to have, like, a good follower account, but they look at what you post. What if she doesn't accept your proposal? We're not gonna even entertain that thought, okay? We're not even... No. That's not gonna happen. Yeah, if... Yeah, I'll look at your profile and then I won't follow, because follow for follow is cringe. She'll love your TikTok, I guess. For follow. I mean, follow for follow is technically TOS. So, I've never believed in the concept of follow for follow. Because it just leads to inflated numbers and poor engagement. Follow for subs? I mean, how many subs are we talking about? That's a whole different thing. Wait, is that a different type of cricket? This one's black, not brown. I think this one's different, huh? What's a bell cricket? Okay. Like I said, how many subs are you talking about? You know, I'm a proud sellout. You know, if that happens, I would just follow and then literally unfollow. Nothing you can do at that point. Yeah, you follow my Twitter and then I don't follow you back. That's how it works here. Moved off the island, it was Yuka. I liked Yuka a lot, but she was a bit too sassy for my taste. You know, I don't like drama. In real life or in game. I play the game to escape IRL drama. I saved the screenshot and gaslight people into thinking I follow you. I mean... As long as it farms more clout for me, I think that's fine. I say this all the time, but if chatters, if you quit the stream and repost them, it's totally fine. Like, I'm never gonna, like, IP someone. Or, I guess, DMCA. Because I know I edit all my own clips and they're very simplistic. Like, I don't add any transitions or VFX. But if people want to use my stream and clip it, go for it. I mean, as long as you're doing it for fun, not for monetary gain, it's fine. How would Clippy be found her? That'd be great, actually. You know, Lemon has only clipped the stream once, and we gotta form our clips from Lemon. I talked about this last week, but I think for the month of October, which individual chatter clips consistently really good moments and also titles their clips well, I'll give VIP to in November. Because, you know, the amount of clips for so far for September have been lacking. You know, we gotta farm more clips for that best of compilation. And I've explained this before, but usually a lot of first-time viewers or people who aren't following the channel will check out the clips tab before anything else. So clips are really good for encouraging people to actually follow the channel. Yes, you have been getting better at clipping. I appreciate it, Crystal. I really do. Shoutouts to the clip chimpers. Maybe I'll try being productive in clip. I think clipping is a really fun way to interact with the stream. Because I know as, what'd you call it? As a viewer, I think it's really fun to think of a good name for a clip. If they check the clip tab now, they'd probably leave. No, I mean, you know what I mean. I mean the people who aren't following the stream. Or like, if I'm offline. That way, like, if somebody can't catch the VOD or the actual stream, they can just watch the top clips of the day, you know? You should do some glitchy movements so we can get some edits in the work. Oh my god, like van cams? Yeah, for VIP, we'll do that in October. I'll formally announce it on Saturday during the art stream. I just realized I can get VIP from clipping VODs. Exactly. Every time I want to clip, it's sub only. Damn.
Peace, I do fan cam.
What? I think fan cams is like the lowest form of content. Like, it's just filters and then cool transitions. That's all it is. The only time I like a fan cam is if it's a Hassan fan cam. Otherwise, I'm not digging it. Or like, dude, I'm self-reporting. Out of every single celebrity, I think the only one that I'm like genuinely attracted to is Jensen Ackles. Oh my god. Even now that he's older, he still looks so nice. Yes, you can clip VODs. But not the sub-only VODs, because I have VODs disabled for substreams. I just looked him up. He's mid. Fuck off, Mac. Shut up. I mean, I like, you know the cliche question, like, who's your celebrity pass? Like, I don't have a celebrity pass. Because in order for me to like someone, or, no, in order to be intimate, I have to like them first. So I can never give anyone a serious answer to the celeb pass. I don't like his facial hair. Guys, stop. Stop. Let me like who I want to like. Come on. Guys are so mean. Tell me that it's all okay. Dude, we can literally craft gold bars. Wait, I need to see this. Infinite money glitch? Well, you can see the light is shining right here. Why would you marry someone you don't even know? Kind of cringe. You sound like a real simp right now. Whoa, with 3 gold nuggets, we can make 6 gold bars. Dude, stonks are up right now. Tell me what am I to do? I think I want to learn how to sing this song. This is one of my friend's favorite Post Malone songs. I want to learn it. Tell me that it's all okay. Okay, I ran out of tickets, so I have to buy more. Sad. How many should I buy? I can only have a crush on someone if I talk to them before. That's kind of what I am. Because I remember in high school, like, I would have a crush on somebody that, like, I found that I, like, found attractive. And then I'd always have, like, a crush on a friend. Dude, I was so cringe. I also confessed to 3 people in high school, and I got rejected every time. Dude, it's so cringe. What TV shows do I like? I'll answer when we get back to the island, that way I can farm for a clip. Honestly, I need more offline content. I'll never have the guts to confess. You sound like a wimp. I mean, honestly, because I have the firm belief, like, if you never try, then it's obviously never gonna work out. Another thing is, only confess if you feel like they feel the same. Because, like, if you confess when you obviously know they don't like you, then it's just putting pressure on them and making them uncomfortable to some capacity. So only confess if you have a feeling they feel the same. Yeah, I totally agree with you, Wolf. Like, I don't think I could ever do a blind date or do, like, hookups. I think it's another thing with, like, safety. Because you don't know, you don't know if they're gonna respect your boundaries and also do adequate consent. So, I feel like I'd have to trust them to some capacity before I date someone. I confess to a straight girl. Me too. Big sad. It's so hard to tell if they possibly like you. No, I feel like you can tell. Because the one relationship I did have, like, oh my god, it's so cute. Like, the origin story was adorable. Like, we were both planning on asking each other out on 4th of July. Because we're gonna go see, like, a fireworks show together, but then we both had to work that night. And we were talking about it afterwards. But we were like, yeah, we're gonna, because, like, we're planning on, like, laying on a blanket and watching the fireworks together, but we both had to cancel because work. And then we got together like 3 days later because we were walking home together, and they asked me out, and I remember, like, I literally stopped walking. Like, I was frozen because I was so shocked, because, like, I was planning on, like, confessing to them the next day, and I like, they came back, like, they kept walking, they turned around, they're like, oh, she's all the way back there, and like, they ran up to me, they're like, are you okay? I'm like, because I'm, like, standing like this because I'm, like, freaking out. Because, like, it was the first time where, like, anybody had ever confessed to me. But at that point, like, we knew that we liked each other, you know? Being low-key bi is a struggle. Yeah, dude, it's... It's one of those things where, like, I like the idea of having a GF, but it's, like, it's... I've never had, so I don't know. It's also hard when, like, if you don't know their sexuality, like, you don't want to, like, ask them out if they're not into women, so. But like I said, if you know, you know. If you have a feeling, it's probably there. Because I feel like if you like someone, there's always, like, natural chemistry. Anyway, chatters, go Gamba. Go Gamba. My first kiss was- oh my god, mine was actually good. It was so cute. It was on a swing set. Dude, looking back, I thought you were wrong 3 times, so shut up. Shut up. Shut up. It was so cute because, we were together for like a week. Oh my god. I'm sharing so much, but I'm comfortable sharing this, but I remember, and they confessed to me, and, like, they walked me home, and I was about to go inside, and they're like, hey, can I give you a kiss? And I'm like, no, because, like, I had never had a kiss before, and I remember, they were like, can I kiss you on the cheek? I'm like, sure, and I remember, like, I was so warm, and then we were together for a week, and we, like, hold hands and stuff, but, like, we didn't kiss until, like, a week after. And then, like, we saw each other every day. mind you. And I remember it was on the swing sets, and it was a really good moment. That's a wholesome, yeah. This was when I was 19, mind you. 19, Chatters. This feels like a FaceTime. No, nobody leak. This is a sub-only stream, so nobody leak. That's foul? What? I think it's wholesome. but looking back, my first ever relationship was really good. Like, they were very respectful. There wasn't anything really bad. If somebody said no, I'd go cold. Oh, is that what you mean? Oh. Well, like I said, I literally had never had a kiss before, so... If you knew your crush would go, you'd ask them out ASAP. See, I wish I had that kind of luck, dude. You've never been in a relationship? I mean, don't pursue one unless you feel like you're ready. Because I feel like a lot of people will get into relationships, especially when they're younger, and not understand that you have to respect your own boundaries and also theirs. And a relationship at its core should be symbiotic, meaning you have to respect yourself and also your partner. Like, we can't only think about what you want, and you can't only think about what they want. Like, you also have to be able to communicate effectively. That way you can avoid, like, an exorbitant amount of, like, arguments or disagreements. Because, of course, there's gonna be times where you disagree, but you have to handle it civilly, maturely. Because you weren't ready? Exactly. If you don't feel like you're ready, don't pursue anyone. And if people try to pursue you, they should be able to respect that. If you don't want to start something too soon. Men are too much work. I mean, I'm not gonna say anything, but I would be ready for at least, like, 30 minutes. Exactly. Oh. Sad. Gonna go home and cry dad now. It's a rat. Their hair is weird, though. Like, it looks like it's long bangs, but it wraps around their nose. Oh, wait. Going back to Cold Bobo's question. What are my favorite TV shows? I don't watch a lot of TV anymore because, you know, like, streaming is now the big thing. I would definitely watch a lot more Twitch and YouTube content now, but in terms of shows that I used to watch, man, PBS shows were my shit. I think my favorites had to be... Oh, Between the Lines was a good one because I used to love reading when I was younger. But I think one of my favorite shows that I will still, like, watch occasionally is Gilligan's Island. It came out, or it aired in the 50s and 60s, I believe. But my mom purchased a few of the season DVD sets so my sister and I could watch them when we were younger. And it's one of those more, like, wholesome comedy shows from the early, mid-1900s. It's very, like, slapstick humor. I enjoyed it a lot. Huh? What? Why are you haunting me? Or are you not haunting me? Oh, I think my favorite PBS show had to be the Ruffman show with Ruffman or some shit like that. I liked it because it featured, like, actual kids and I thought it was cool. You did not expect that? Yeah, I don't watch a lot of, like, produce shows anymore. I just watch a lot of online content. The Wild Kratts! Oh my god, that's another one! And also Zaboomaboo! Oh my god. Yes, that was another pretty solid one. Yeah, because we didn't have cable when I was younger, so the only, like, shows we had was PBS. And, like, I know that PBS is, like, is funded by, like, the church. So there's a lot of, like, underlying religious tones to some of the shows, but, you know, it's free cartoons. Wadcrats suck. Mods ban Mac. Not joking, ban Mac. They're behaving way too much. Arthur was good. Yes, Arthur was another good one. But I feel like Arthur and all the kids were kind of mean. Cyber Chase? I heckin' love Cyber Chase. Dude, why is Mac here with the bad takes today? What is wrong? Arthur was mean? Yeah, Arthur was mean. Did you ever watch Total Drama? Yes! I loved it so much. You know why? It's because I loved watching Survivor 2 when I was younger. Because I think Survivor was one of the few reality shows that my parents let me watch. So, like, Total Drama is, like, just like Survivor, but with, like, high schoolers. Animated. And, dude, it was so good. I think the gimmick of having, like, the confessional booth in any type of reality show is so good. Because you can see how, like, delusional people are. Or, like, how, like, egocentric they are. I think it's so entertaining. Kirby had an anime? I know Sonic had a show. You're named after a Survivor cast member? Dude, that's wild. And my axe broke. I'm really mad. Dude, that's crazy. I don't know the show, 16. Oh, my foot's asleep. I mean, Wilk got the joke. Oh, I'm mad that I have to buy an axe. I packed three, but half of them were apparently busted. Guys, we're almost 2 hours into stream. This is crazy. Wait, what did... I want to see what that Survivor member actually looks like, because I don't know if I've seen that season. I hit your main things once. Take a- oh! Sorry. I accidentally opened up Kai's stream. Because I accidentally clicked on the notification. Lmao. Oh my god, Connor's pants title is FaZe Connor. Fire emoji. Dude. Connor's one of my favorite, like, kind of small but big streamer. World of Gumball? I fucking hated that show. It was, like, all over the place. I didn't like it. My sister liked it more. Okay, Colby Survivor. Who the fuck is this guy? A Survivor Outback? What? I have no idea who the Colby guy is. Who, Megalol? I think maybe I just missed that season. I mean, either way, cool story. Cool story, kid. Oh, he was in multiple seasons? Oh, okay. And I probably saw him at some point then. What about Crowder? Crowder was another one I didn't like. It was a bit too, like, too much going on. Oh my god, you know what's another show I liked? I liked Austin and Ally solely because I shipped Austin and Ally so much. Like, I remember I'd watch every episode. We didn't have cable, so anytime I was able to go to, like, a friend's house and watch, or my grandma's house. And, like, I remember I would just sit and watch the whole episode and, like, nitpick every single interaction they had. To see if they were, like, actually together. Ross Lynch, no. Little Einsteins? Ugh! I never really liked Little Einsteins. Little Einsteins. It's never my thing. Oh, big fish. Hold. I'm gonna catch it this time. Never mind. I think Ross Lynch is okay. Kukai again? Ooh, a shark? I'll take that. Chris Hemsworth? I don't like celebs. Only celeb that I like is Jensen Ackles. And that's it. Jensen's better than Roz. Ooh. I think it's because, like, I don't like people who look young, I've noticed. Like, I like people who look more mature. Concerning men. Oh, I just realized the album looped. I gotta find another album. Oh, I can finish this one. See, who do I wanna listen to? Oh, this motherfucker's so far from me. It's been a while since I've listened to Dawn FM. Like, the whole album. Hi, Kingling. Welcome in, hun. We're doing well today, man. Biggest flag ever, yeah. I mean, to me, I think immaturity isn't that much a problem if it's not emotional immaturity. Like, I hate when people can't empathize or understand how you feel. Because I think I'm fairly mature, but I'm immature in the sense of, like, I lack perspective. Like, lived experience on some things. Like, that's how I kind of see myself as immature. Yeah, let's get more axes. Okay, let's go on our next expedition. What's my biggest red flag? Okay, stop. We got a far for a clip. I have to actually think on that. You know what else chatters can think about? Participating in the prediction, because we are heading into another island, another chance of finding the love of my life. Because, like, there's different tiers of red flags. There's red flags to where it's an immediate thing, where you don't want to go on, like, let's say a second date, and there's some red flags that come up later. Like, i.e. flags that could allude to, like, potential abuse. So, there's, like, different types. I need to think. We could probably dive into, like, both types, but I thought we couldn't clip sub only. Oh, is it letting you clip? Lamau. I mean, if it does let you clip, then go for it. I don't care. If it does allow you to clip, the only issue would be is if someone watches the clip and there's an option to, like, watch the whole stream. They wouldn't be able to watch it because the VOD's gonna be gone. Raising volume for this topic? Exactly. Yeah, I agree. Red flags that come up later in a relationship are not necessarily harder to identify, but it's a lot harder to get out of a separate relationship. Okay, I need to actually think. Can somebody think of a lighter question? Can somebody think of a better... not a better question, but like a lighter one? That way I have some time to think. Because there's several paths that can take this conversation down, and I want to be respectful. Oh, they're cute! Look at them! But you know what? That's not her. Not good enough for us. What's my favorite Yoshi color? I think green. You know, green is pretty standard. You know, gotta be classic. I think because Yoshi's saturated green stands out so much. Is that Yuka? No. It is a koala, but it's not Yuka. Better question, how dare you? No, I mean like a lighthearted one. What type of pasta would you be if you were a type of pasta? What's the fattest pasta you can buy? I'm kidding. Guys, I'm joking. No, piece or two, gasp. Do I have any squishmallows? No, I don't. Squishmallows are so cringe. I've told myself I'm never gonna purchase stuffed animals because I know once I purchase one, I'm never gonna stop. That's why I just have one Pikachu. I did see somebody post about how the Pokemon Center shop is gonna have sleeping animals as a plushie line. Oh no. I was like, I'm not gonna do it. Megan does not have the money to spend on stuffed animals. You know, it's also cringe watching ads on Twitch. Nice try, Chatter. Oh. Was that an ad debate? Exactly one stuffed animal? And you should keep it that way, Kingly. Like, please do. Was that... Oh, was that not an ad debate? Were you just calling Mac cringe? That's kind of mean, but also kind of funny. Squishmallows are so cute. I will not allow for squishmallow defenders in chat. Kind of cringe. Okay, should we talk about red flags now? It was an ad transition? No, it's too early! It's too early! Another reason why I try and do the ad either like a minute before or after is the way I have to trim my VOD down, I cut it into like hour-long segments. So if I- fuck! I'm gonna pass out. If I transition the ad near that hour mark, then it allows for the... You guys wouldn't get it. Because if I have a 3-hour VOD, I have to cut it into 3 1-hour sections. Is it... It's all... No, we got 7 more minutes to the end, guys. Hold. How do I make you fall for me? Okay, let's have the red flag discussion now. Because it seems like chat is flinging some red flags right now at me. When talking about red flags, I think there are two types. There are red flags that show up immediately, like when you go on a first date or when you're first starting to like have a friendship. And then there's some subtle red flags that come up later in a relationship once you become more comfortable, once you're living together, when you're together for maybe like 6 months. In terms of like immediate red flags, I think one that really bothers me is when somebody is super disrespectful to other people in public or service workers, i.e. if they kind of like don't hold the door open for other people, if they're walking into the store and there's people behind them, or if they're really rude to service workers. Because to me, if you can't show decent like humanity or respect to strangers, then how are you gonna respect me, right? In terms of like long-term red flags, I think one that is definitely for me is having them look through your phone. That is something that I've talked about in the past. And it's obviously something that if they can't respect your own self-identity and your privacy, then they probably don't trust you to the fullest extent that they should. One for, like, a typical red flag for me that doesn't bother me is if someone doesn't want you to meet their family. I think that's totally fine because I understand everybody has a different family dynamic. Everybody has their own share of trauma from their family, so I don't necessarily need to meet their family if they don't want me to. It's different if they feel like I'm a bad influence, then that is obviously a problem. I think another red flag that a lot of my friends told me was not okay was your current partner still communicating with their ex-partner. That is something that didn't bother me, because it was an issue that did come up in a previous relationship. Like, they, their ex tried to communicate with them, like, not with the intent of, like, hooking up, because they knew that he was in a current relationship with me. Because, like, I have the understanding that, you know, people can still be civil, you can still be mature, you can still talk to people. It's just, like, I don't think it should be appropriate for them to hang up. Because, like, he never hung out with her when we were together. And, like, even now, I still communicate fairly often with an ex-partner. Because, like, you know, they're still, like, my best friend. Even after we were together for a while and split up for a while. Like, I still see them as someone separate than an ex. I think it's so disrespectful to label them just as ex as a label. And they were so much more than that, you know? Because we were friends before we went out, so... Someone asking to turn on your locations? Dude, that is some psycho shit. Like, actually. I don't think anybody should be able to know where you are at any given time. I think it's so invasive. Because, like, I know when I was in high school, because I used to walk to school, my parents, like, almost forced me into getting one of those tracker apps. Like, I understand why they want to do that, but it's like, if I did go missing, you can always track my phone through your phone provider. You don't need to have an app to track me, like, all times of the day. Ooh, but when does a red flag become a white flag? I think some red flags are different with certain people. Like, it comes down to everybody has their own sense of boundaries and things that they don't mind. Like, you know how I said I don't mind when people talk to their exes? I think that's fine. As long as they're not doing anything malicious, I think it's fine. It's still a cause for concern, but it's not a major red flag. Yeah, exactly. Like, literally, same thing. Like, I went to school and came home. Like, I was not doing bad shit. I think your biggest red flag is clingy people. I'm kind of clingy. But I'm not, like, overly clingy. Like, one thing, This happens a lot. It's like, I will never get upset if somebody doesn't text me back, right away. Because I have the understanding, like, you know, I am not their whole world and their whole life. Like, they need to have a separate identity from me, their partner. So, you know, if they don't reply back after an hour or two, that's fine. If they're working, they should not have... You should not feel like you're obligated to their attention. Like, you know, I'm fairly, quick on replying to people, usually. But I can respect if somebody doesn't text me back right away. That's totally fine. Location tracking apps are dangerous in some cases. It depends on, like, what... It's a very tricky thing. The location sharing shit. It's like... You don't want your location shared to people who shouldn't know your location. Is essentially, I think it's why it's not okay. I think the reason why a majority of apps will ask if you want to share your location is so they can track which ads to send you. It's like cookies too. You knows? You know? Dude, I cannot talk. You know what else I've been keeping track of? The time, because chatters, we are 2 hours in the stream, so it's time for me to run a few minutes of ads. But you can avoid those ads for subscribing for $4.99, just $5. You get your coffee and get ad free viewing all month long. That was. I tried. Anyway, if you're a non sub watching a sub only stream, what are you doing? You can subscribe and you can watch the whole stream and also chat in the sub only chat room. That'd be pretty cool, huh? Also, chatters, we are in the final 5 days of September, meaning you only have 5 days left of September. All new tier 1s, multi-month recurring subs, and tier upgrades are 20% off. Wow. The lighting's amazing. Yes, I know. I know. I could have this type of lighting during a normal stream, but I would have to have lights. I would have to have 3 lights. Because in order to get decent lighting, you need to have a light left, right, and, like, behind you, below. You know what else is a red flag? Ads, Lomao. Sure, that would have been good. Anyway, that ad is coming, so subscribe so you don't have to see ads. Get some water, get a snack if you need it, chatters. I drank this whole thing of water. That's a lot. I was born in the city. Do you think the new place I'm looking at will have good lighting? No. Like I said, nothing is set in stone yet, but it's basically like we're probably gonna get it. I don't want to leak, but the rooms that I would be occupying would not have sunlight, which is fine. I would just have to invest in more lights, which is a-okay. I know. Like, imagine we had this natural lighting the whole time. It'd be amazing. What's my favorite anime? Ooh. Can we hold on that question? That way I can farm for a clip. Guys, you need to ask the questions when we're actually playing the meat of the game. Yep, okay, go. Do you have lights right now? Yes. Yeah, hi, Aku. Yeah, isn't your profile pic literally Ryu? Or Ru? Ryu? Well, I have two ring lights, but one was flickering, so I technically only have one. I cry during haiku every time I watch. I think that's a problem. I think the only time I cried is during season 3, during like the final round. I think the reason why is because like the sports animes are so like emotional. Like everybody's like so into the game. Oh, Nishinoya. Wait, Ru is the bald guy! Wait, no. Fuck. Wait, who is Ru? Isn't Ru the ball guy? I haven't watched Hayek in a long time. Uh-oh. Your anime you've watched, Sting and Rambo? Yeah, that is kind of awkward. You need to watch some more. Tanaka, that's it. I was close. Okay, well, chatters, you know what time it is. It is once again time for you to forfeit your channel points and predict if you think we will find her on this attempt. Is it ad time? No, we just did an ad. You were here for the ad break, yeah, goof. Oh, Bleach? I think I've read like 200 of the manga chapter and then I got bored. My sister is in the process of watching all the older Bleach episodes right now. Okay, going back to the original question. What is my favorite anime? I think my all-time favorite anime and manga has to be Fruits Basket. I think my first ever anime that I watched was Ouran High School Host Club, so that is another one that is special to me. But I think Fruits Basket, the main protagonist is so wholesome and sweet. And also the manga, I like the illustration style a lot. The only thing I didn't like about the original anime is that they kind of made Toru, that was named Toru, seem really selfish in the final episode, and I got really mad. Because, like, she's just super caring and kind throughout the whole series. Yeah, I really like the remake for Fruits Basket. I haven't finished it all. But I need to go back and finish the remake at some point. Yes, it did have to do with the Zodiacs. I think the concept was also interesting. Because essentially, whenever one of the family Zodiac members, embraced, so like hugged someone of the opposite sex, they would transform into an animal. I never really got into Hunter x Hunter. I try, but I couldn't. I'm not too big a fan of shonen. I am such a sucker for like romance animes though, like, oh my god, I love shipping characters. If there's any type of, like, harem or, like, love triangle dynamic, oh my god, I eat that shit up. More so than anime, I've been really into K-dramas recently. Similar vein, like, I'm such a sucker for anything romance.
look back now and I realize.
Thoughts on fan fiction? Oh no. I might get a lot of hate for this one. Wattpad 2? Yep. Oh no. I'm gonna self-report. In late middle school and early high school, I didn't write any Wattpad fanfiction, but I was really into reading it. I'm self-reporting, but you know. That's what I was into. Because I know whenever I would watch shows, I liked, I guess, thinking of headcanons to myself, like theorizing what was like the underlying meanings and like dynamics between characters in the show. I think that's why I like fanfiction so much. Like, I know there's different genres of fanfiction, and what I will say is I consumed all genres, okay? That's all I will say. If you know, you know. I'm trying to think of what fandoms I was into. Of course, I was into Supernatural. I think I was really into, like, Haikyuu. Oh my god, Yuri on Ice? Dude. I think those were the only, like, fan fictions I really got into. Yeah, I think those are like the three main ones. No, I think, okay, I think the OC fan fictions are so goddamn cringe. They're so fucking cringe. Or like the Times Reader fan fictions, where like you kind of like insert the reader into the story. I think those are even fucking cringier. Oh my god, that's so cute. Writing fanfiction, even knows fanfiction, that's adorable. I mean, I think it's like a really like nice creative outlet for some people to have, as long as you don't... Okay. The one thing I will clarify about fanfiction, I think it's fine for people to write fiction about fictional characters, but I don't think it's appropriate for people to write fanfictions about actual celebrities or actors. I think that is inappropriate. Like, the people who do, like, fanfictions of, like, celebrity Times Reader or, like, celebrities, like, interacting with each other, I think that's weird. Because, like, that's a real person you're talking about. I think it's weird. Yeah, like, you saw that with, like, a lot of, like, YouTubers and stuff in, like, the early days. I just think it's inappropriate. Oh, bye, Wolf! I'm sorry, I didn't say bye in time. Bye, Wolf! We'll see you next time. I'm sorry, Un. Thank you, chatters, for saying bye to me. You guys are so cute.
Put a bill on and off, yeah.
Oh my god, so many bees. Not the bees.
And you didn't expect to.
You know, that wasn't Aurora, that was just a hot pink tiger. Sag. And Christy, you're literally self-reporting right now. Why are you self-reporting? I literally just said Time Reader fanfictions are like the most degen.
I'll never fall. So here we go again. Ooh. Ooh. Here we go again. Life's a dream.
I'm trying to learn the vocals for this part. I think it's really pretty. You know, I say, oh, I'm learning this song, I'm learning the vocals on this song. I literally never do. I just like to say that. Guys, I don't know what Kakashi is. Okay, chatters, let's change the topic. Don't be weird. Don't be weird. Okay, chatters, want to give me another question? If you don't know what song you're talking about, look at the screen. It's on screen. Are you blind? You know what Twitch first introduced the seeing or watching without seeing and watching without hearing badges? It's funny because a lot of people didn't know that those were added in terms of like disability awareness and accessibility, because the only place they announced it was on their Twitter and then like the Twitch blog, and not many people follow their blog or like their main Twitter account. Like, even some bigger creators had no idea what the badges meant. So, like, a lot of people use the badges to troll and be like, oh, I'm watching the stream without audio, well, meow. To, like, troll the streamer. But I think it's very unfortunate that it wasn't communicated properly to the Twitch community and user base that they were meant as accessibility tools and not to fuck around and shit. What's my favorite Mario Party? I like the Superstars, because that's the only one I really played. I don't have, like, distinct memories of playing, like, older versions. My favorite fruit? Ooh. I think mango's pretty solid. Ooh, also a good peach or an apricot. Ooh. I like juicy fruit. But I don't like pineapple. I think pineapple, it tastes like too stringy. You've never played Mario Party? Huh? Well, you need to, hun. At some point. Should we do Mario Party for next month? Next month's tourney? Or should we do a different game? You have a Switch? Then you should buy the game. No, I'm literally never doing Smash because I suck at Smash. No. No. No, I ain't ever playing Smash. It's because, like, I'm not good at the game. I'm not gonna play a game I'm bad at on stream. I'm already bad at games. Why would I play a game I'm bad at on stream and be more of an embarrassment? Oh, you never played a, like, party boards games? Oh, dude, I cannot fucking talk. You've never played party board games. That's fine. And it's basically like mini games and then just RNG luck. So, nothing crazy. No, I'm not gonna play Among Us with chat. That's cringe. And don't you kinda need voice chat? I mean, you can definitely play without voice, but it's a lot more difficult, right? Okay, clumsy. I played Monopoly once. Me too. I never understood, like, reselling property in Monopoly, though. When I was younger, I never understood the mechanic. Oh yeah, we were gonna do Uno for 1 month. I forgot. So the only game I can think of I can play. Well, you need to save up and buy Switch. Is it cross-platform, though? And Uno was his name-o. You know what movie I want to watch? I want to watch The Sound of Music. I remember we had that on VHS. I don't have a job. Me too, man. Me too. I mean, does streaming count as a job? I kind of treat it like my job, though. Guys, I gaslight you guys into subscribing every stream, so that's normal for you guys. I'm not gaslighting, I'm politely encouraging.
Is there someone else or not? Cause I wanna keep you close. I don't wanna lose my spot. Cause I need to know if you're hurting him or you're hurting me.
Aw, dude, I almost had it. The difficulty with singing is, like, it's hard for me to, like, breathe in. Should I start streaming? I mean, why not? We did talk about batteries and shit earlier. You should just know what you're getting into before you start, because it's a lot of equipment to invest in money-wise, and it can also be, like, very emotionally taxing. So just know everything before you get into it. Splatoon 3, maybe. I've never played it, though, so... Maybe we can do Splatoon next month for a Meggy Sports event? Because we're gonna be doing Splatoon for a bonus stream. I only have a phone. Well, Cuter Lee was doing phone streams for a while. Because she had to sell her PC. Whoa, I bought a lot of axes. That's a lot. Oh my god. You could do like IRL streams. That is basically like live vlogs. Stream Genshin on phone screen. I think you can screen mobile games. Actually, I think. I know you can do that on TikTok. In light of all the, like, recent Twitch news, I genuinely don't think I won't switch platforms. Because the idea of multi-streaming is fine, but that's not the path I want to take. Because I think it's very important when you're very small to encourage your viewer base to type in the chat room, get used to your vibe, environment. And if you're multi-streaming, you're obviously going to be neglecting one aspect of your community. And I don't think that's good for the audience to actually enjoy what you do. Yeah, and TikTok lives are kind of mid. But people expect mid content on TikTok, so it makes sense.
My girl.
Hey chatters, it is time once again for me to ask for your points. Everybody, peace, I do pray. Do you think we will find her on this island? Go Gamba?
It's way too strong. Let me be there. Let me be there for your home.
I can't think of any spicy questions. Oh, get on it!
I'm making my responsibility.
Losing 1k points was not worth it. I mean, I think it was funny for the gag. But the fun thing about predictions is when somebody gambles big, it encourages other people to gamble big as well. So, you know, returns could be worth it. He no sight of a villager just yet. Vegas, baby! You know, I think Twitch... It'd be great if they could ban all forms of gambling, but Twitch predictions, please let them stay. Please. Because it's not like it's real money, it's just channel points. It's just people's valuable time that they're spending away. thoughts on Doja Cat's music? I think it's fine. I haven't listened to any of her songs that weren't mainstream. I think it's fine. Like, I usually don't skip it if it's on. I think it's because I don't listen to a lot of new music now. Like, once I find an artist or a song type I like, I usually stay in that niche. Thoughts on every type of vegetable? I hate vegetables. They make me really mad. I know they're good for me, and that's why I hate them. I think it's because, like, the texture isn't there for me. Like, I very much prefer cooked vegetables, like stewed veggies, over raw. I hate raw veggies. Like, sometimes I can snack on snap peas, and that's it. I think we'll go for 3 hours today, because we already streamed for 3 hours earlier. So we probably have time for, like, maybe 2 or 3 more islands if I speedrun. Oh my god, the best single from the album is coming up! I should have said thoughts on Beyoncé's new album. I haven't listened to it. I only know songs if they're on the radio. Like, I don't actively seek out an artist's work unless I know them. Or, like, if I like their work. Like, the only new album that I've sat down and listened to was Dawn FM. But I play League so I can stay calm. I mean, do you get angry when you play League? I don't think there's been any game that'll make me actually rage and get mad. There's been a few times where, like, Fall Guys, I've, like, gotten upset, more so at myself, because I'll mess up and, like, get so close to getting a crown and then I absolutely throw. But I don't think a game has made me legitimately mad. And the only time I, quote-unquote, get mad is if I'm faking for a reaction to either make chat laugh or, like, annoy my sister. Like, she doesn't think it's funny, she just thinks it's annoying, and then I do it to annoy her. You get mad when playing Pokemon Unite? Dude, I used to be so into Unite and I haven't played for a long ass time. And, like, mind you, I was never that good. I played Greninja all the time because I relied so heavily on the double team mechanic. No! I believe you could die for me. Ecstasy. And this time I know for sure. I don't know how many hours I have in Unite. Unite used to be a stream game for me. But not a lot of people watched it. Because, like, I think Unite is, there's not a lot of audience for it, unfortunately. I remember a streamer friend was telling me, they were like, you need to stop playing Unite on stream. Like, literally nobody watches you. And that's when I was averaging, like, 2 or 3 viewers a stream. And I was like, yeah, but I like the game. And she was like, no, you need to stop playing it. And I was like, okay. And then I stopped like 2 weeks after. I think I switched Unite for a Mario game. My 11-year-old cousin has 1k hours in Fortnite. Thoughts? I think they should go pro, actually. You know, when kids are younger, they got those quicker reflexes. You know, you can mold them into little pro Fortnite gamer like Ninja or some shit. So I say, let them have it. Let them have fun. Let them be a little sweaty gamer. You know, it has a bigger audience than YouTube. Really? Really? What'll happen to the streamer spider? I haven't seen that spider in a while. Actually, I think I might have killed it. Because I saw a spider that was similar in size the other day, and I flicked it, and then it died. So I think I might have murked it. Okay, I'm gonna listen to this song again. I'm actually gonna have it on loop for a little bit, because this is my favorite single. Does anybody else, when they hear a new song and they really like it, they'll loop it on repeat for like hours? What's my favorite song? That's a loaded question. Or top three? Okay, that's a bit better. Top three is a bit better. I still need to think. I'm not the type of person to associate songs with memories or like certain people. But I said the story before, but one of my key memories is with my previous partner, we were sitting in a park and they were braiding my hair and I sang Always by Panic at the Disco for them. That's one of my favorite memories of all time. So I think that song has a very special place in my heart. It's hard to like think of specific songs. It's one of those things like if I hear it, then I'm like, oh yeah, that's the one. That song kind of gets older. Shut up, don't shit on my opinions. Are you a secret A washer? I can take another heartbreak or I'll end it all. Well, this is my favorite part. And now I know she wasn't right for me. Destiny. Oh, I sang the wrong verse! Dang it, I need to learn this song again. I actually want to see my, like, saved songs on my main account. Don't let me down, please. Don't break my heart. Don't break my heart. I'm falling apart already. Oh, one of my favorite songs in like middle school was Payphone by Maroon 5. That was one of my favorites. That's another one. I think Tattoo by Jordan Sparks is another one that I really enjoy. I like a lot of Jordan Sparks' more popular songs. I think one of my more favorite, like... Oh, okay. Did you see the Adam Levine stuff? A little bit. But let's not talk about drama. I think a song that I instantly fell in love with was Love Someone by Lucas Graham. I discovered this song because I was playing Type Racer one day. And the chorus of the song came up. Because it goes...
When you love someone, you open up your heart. When you love someone, you make room.
Like, it's such a beautiful song that I instantly loved. Yeah, I agree. The Twitter memes are pretty good. I think that's the only good thing that's coming out of that situation. What else? In terms of like edgier songs, I really liked I'd Rather Drown by Sudadoff. That's another good one. Yeah, I think those are my top few.
But I know you're right for me.
I don't like when people compare me to other figures. Anytime I get a comment saying like, oh, you look like Rainy Rodriguez, I automatically delete them. Because I think it's weird. Yeah, exactly. I don't know if they're making fun of me or not. Because, like, I don't know too much about Rooney, and I don't know if, like, she likes the meme culture that was kind of built around her. And I don't like to entertain those people. Oh my god, rare bug! I usually delete them. And I think the punchline of, oh my god, you look like this person is such, like, a stupid punchline. Queenie blocked me, so no, she hates it. Okay, got it. Got it. Got it, Buzz. What'd you do? I think it's also like, I hate when jokes are used over and over again. That would annoy me too.
I'm falling apart already. Don't you? I should.
Yeah, I have to change my ISO again. Hold chatters. Because it's gotten a little bit darker. See how that drastically changes my skin tone? Isn't that kind of crazy? I think this is good. Because the sun is starting to set. No, I wasn't on my phone. I was changing my camera settings. Never mind. Right, exactly. Let's see, how many tickets do we have left? We have none. Sad. Ooh, infused water dispense? Ooh, that sounds pretty good. Oh. I mean, that's still cute. Okay, chatters. I think I have time for one more island. So let's do one more attempt. Okay, I'm gonna change the song now. Getting tired of it now. Yeah, I don't think I've been blocked by anybody. Or if I have, I don't know I have. So, let's go. You're not blocked anymore? Ayo. Oh, I have to empty my inventory, Lomao.
Is there someone else or not? 'Cause I wanna keep you close. I don't wanna lose my spot. 'Cause I need to know if you're hurting him or you're hurting me.
Why am I tired? It's only 6 p.m., guys. Did I sleep? I did not. I just remember. I woke up at 4 a.m. today. And then I could not go back to sleep. Because, I was texting my friend last night, and we were trying to figure out bus routes, like, to the new property if we were to move there. And we were texting till, like, 10, and then I fell asleep. And then they texted me back at 11, but I didn't get it until I woke up. So I was frantically, like, searching, like, bus routes and shit. At 4 a.m. Then I couldn't go back to sleep. I mean, I was probably the psycho one for texting them at 4 in the morning. But then it's like, if I didn't send it, I would forget, you know? Anyway. Chatters, this is the last island. The last attempt of the day. Everybody, peace out to Prey and also Gamma. Do you think we will find her? Please, we haven't seen any penguins today, I don't think. Do you like Drag Race? It's not my type of content, but I can appreciate the art. I know Drag Race is a very integral part of queer culture. And I don't like when people associate drag races with trans people. Because not all trans people do drag. And not all drag people, or people who do drag, are trans. I think that's a very false equivalency that people make when they don't know what it is. I think it's an art form, and I think it's really interesting. Because it's a mean of self-expression as well. What is your favorite thing that you shouldn't eat but you want to? Mine is soap. I buy my fingernails. You guys know that. You shouldn't be eating your fingernails. How'd I catch that? That was crazy. I chopped my nails off for real. For real. On God, on God. Oh my God, you know what else looked delicious? Like shampoo. You know, we're not gonna repost this clip because we don't want to be banned for, like, encouraging kids to eat shampoo. But, like, I remember when I was little, I would mix, like, quote-unquote potions with shampoo. Because, like, you know, some shampoos have, like, glitter powder in them. And I remember, like, it looked so, like, I wanted to, like, take a sip. Oh. Sad. Mermaid potion video. Yeah, exactly. Sad. Well, guys, it seems like today is not the day. Just drink water. Guys, my water cup is empty, though. There was a little bit left. God damn it. Oh, man. That was good. Okay, chatter who doesn't know what makes a good clip. That would be a good clip. There was like a few sips of water left in the cup. Oh, that's funny. I mean, it's fine. The pants I'm wearing is, they're waterproof, so it's fine. Also, my chair is fairly waterproof. So no biggie. The album's almost over. Sad. Yeah, when I was playing Stardew Valley, I didn't play Animal Crossing as much, but then once I started playing Animal Crossing again, I haven't touched Stardew Valley. I think Stardew Valley is a game you should try. But it's a lot of grinding. So if you like games where you have to like grind and build up your base, I think you would like it. There's also, like, a lot of subtle storytelling in it as well. What? Well, here we go. Now we got the recommended songs again. Oh, okay. I think another one of my favorite songs is Die For You by The Weeknd. The It's another solid one. I think my favorite Weekend songs has to be Don't Break My Heart. Also, Gasoline is pretty solid. This single, Call It My Name, and also Die For You. Those are my top three Weekend songs. I think Die For You should be in, like, my top three songs, like, of all time. I'm sad that I didn't think about it.
When does we're wrong, the nature I have, you close to me.
Oh, you don't like The Weeknd? Sad. I mean, a lot of his more recent stuff has become, like, more produced and also, like, kind of more mainstream and also, like, I guess more digestible. That's fine if you don't like it.
Why can't you wait, baby?
Sorry, I'm just like, I'm actually like listening to the song. You don't really listen to The Weeknd? Sad, come on. I like a lot of his shit. You know, I would play music for you guys to hear, but I'm so scared of getting DMCA'd, because now they can DMCA people live. I mean, I don't think it happens very often, but I'm still scared. Yeah, I agree. I think R&B is a really solid genre as well. Like, most R&B I can, like, immediately get into.
Girl, why can't you wait till I fall out of love?
This song is so good. This is like one of the songs I listen to when I'm like upset. Cause like it's still emotional and also kind of edgy enough to like get my feelings out.
Oh my way. Oh my way.
It's kind of sad how a lot of artists with a lot of good music are super problematic. I think it's one of those things where in some cases you can be able to separate the art from the artist, but whenever somebody does like actual crime or like violating other people, like grooming or assault, it's kind of like, I find those to be unjustifiable personally. Like, but if they're like a jerk or like kind of like a shitty person, as long as they don't do like illegal crime, I think that's somewhat forgivable. I think a lot of people, especially now, will equate drama and minimize like actual crime and horrible things that people do, whether it be exploitation, assault, and that type of thing. But people need to understand that you can't minimize those type of things. Like, in the real world, if not online, like if someone were to pursue those charges, they'd be in jail. So I think it's wildly inappropriate for people to call things of such severity drama. Like I said, there's, in certain instances, you should be able to separate the art from the artist, but when they do crimes, they should not be platformed. Simple as that. Way too based. Okay, well, guys, we have spent nearly 3 hours searching, and it is another attempt in which we did not find her. We are back home, stung up by bees. Maybe we might actually see an aurora borealis. Let's see. Because it's nearing sundown in my area. It's almost 7. Or we'll see a sunset. Oh, yeah, because aurora borealis only come out at night. But look at that lovely sunset, you know, bioenergy representation, I guess. So I think we can go ahead and wrap up stream here. But Chatters, I would like it if you could stay in the stream because we might be able to raid today. I know we usually don't raid during some of these streams, but you know, someone is live today that we have never been able to raid. And I would love to raid out to them. So everybody who's here, please stay in the stream. Stay around for the raid. Let's go ahead and save the game here. But I would like to thank everyone who came to stream any Chatter Zerkers. I appreciate everybody. Thank you for hanging out during this special later sub-only stream. I appreciate everybody. Also, once again, thank you to everybody who helped support the stream earlier to help unlock this bonus stream. We had Emmy, Mac, and Batty, and myself help get enough subs to unlock this bonus stream. So thank you, everybody, help support. We haven't raided out to somebody in a long time, so let's refresh the rules. We only raid out to channels I know, so please be nice in the chat rooms. I only raid out to streamer friends. Today, we are gonna be raiding out to Emmy Beef. She hasn't been live in a while because she's been having some tech issues, but we've never been able to raid out to Emmy because she usually streams at like 8 p.m. my time, so 11 a.m. or 11 p.m. PST. So this is the one of the times where we can actually hang out with Emmy. She's doing just chatting. She's probably catching up with the chat room. So I would love it if everybody could politely copy and paste the raid message into her chat. It is peace raid or peace A2 spin, peace raid. Everybody should be a sub, so y'all should have the sub emote. This is my first raid with you. Ayo! People pog. Wow. Also, Genderbinder, be nice to whoever we raid to. You reflect my channel. Don't be rude or mean in their chat. You'll get banned here. Also, don't feel obligated to chat if you don't want to. I mean, she's pretty chill. She reads every single chat message, so she will give you all the attention you want. You know, she doesn't ignore you like I do, okay? Super nice. So if you guys could politely drop her some follows when we go over there. And if anybody has any bits or subs laying around, you should give them to her because she's very cool. She's also like kind of like not the shy type, but she's kind of more reserved. So like, you know, get her talking, guys. We won't punch you. Anyway, chatters, remember copy and paste the raid message. We're gonna go ahead and raid out to friend of the show, Emmy Beef. I will see you guys Tuesday with Eastward. I'll see you guys Tuesday. Once again, thank you to everybody who came to stream today. I had fun hanging out with everyone. I hope you guys all enjoy the rest of your day. And I'll see you guys later. Okay, bye.